Hey, what's up, everybody? It's Overseer. On past Sunday, I preached a message entitled In the Middle of It. It talks about Shema standing in the middle of a field fighting the Philistines, and God gave him the battle. We related to being in the middle of situations, but if you are in the middle of anything, don't retreat, don't back up, because the same distance for you to advance is the same distance for you to retreat. So if you're in the middle of it, you might as well fight. And I guarantee you, if you stand with God, God will stand with you. His promises says that we know that all things work together for the good to them that love God and to them that are the called according to his purpose. So stand right there. Watch God move on your behalf. Let's go into a little bit of the message and see a highlight that we shared yesterday. God bless you. Talk to you.
Watch this. Against the Philistines. The text here tells us he stood, watch this, right in the middle of it. He stood right in the middle of it. In other words, here we go, he refused to run. He stood, watch this, to defend that which God promised. God has promised you some things in your life, and you can't be a coward and not face it and run and abort the promise that God intended for you to have. The Bible says that he stood right there in the middle of the war, wasn't moving, flat-footed, and saying, I ain't going nowhere till God bless me. When God has showed you something, you stand on the promise of God and do what it is that it takes, come hell or high water, to receive the promise. I'm over here. Because if God said it, shall he not make it good? If he spoke it, shall it not come to pass? He's not a God that he shall lie, nor a son of man that he shall repent. If God says a thing, you can bank on it. You just got to wait on God. You can't manufacture or manipulate it or mandate it by yourself. If God showed it to you, wait on him to deliver the promise. And sometimes God knows it gets lonely. It gets frustrating trying to wait on something and don't know what it is. I don't know how and I don't know when, but I'm still holding on to the promise. That means you got to have faith in God. You got to trust God when you can't trace God. You got to learn how to walk by faith and not by sight. When you can't see that thing, you still got to believe it. I need somebody to say something to me right there. If you can do it by yourself, Shay, you don't need God. But when it's too much for you, it's just right for God. That's why you ought to throw up your hands right now and say, God, I give it unto you. I'm going to let go and let God and let God have his way. I got to do it. It must get done. And I'm believing God for it. This great warrior stood in the middle of that field. And the Bible says he fought and killed the Philistines. And God blessed him to win a great battle. Let me stop parenthetically and pause and pose a question or give you submittance, my brothers and sisters, that we have to learn, watch this, to stand still. Get that word right there. All too often, Jamila, we run because it appears though our battles and our situations and our problems is too big. Come on, talk back to me if you can. God will allow some honorable problems to come into your life to make sure your faith is genuine. He will test your faith. He will cause you to go through some things that's uncomfortable and put you in some uncomfortable, precarious situations and make you feel that his love has been bereft from you. But God is working on some things behind the scenes to develop your character, so when he gets you to your next workstation, you won't abort it because you're weak. Come on, say amen. You're not skirmish. You're not pusillanimous. You're not timid. Glory to God. But you have enough ability to say, if God brought me through this, he surely can take me through that. So God take you through some stuff to test your character, to develop your integrity, to make sure your gift won't take you where your character can't keep you. So he will test you. He will build you. He will hurt you. He will make you. He will mold you so that he can trust you to give you his best.